physique, my body, you know, getting into healthy, because health is number one, you know. So I think just even whether it's boxing or not, whether it's boxing shit is real or not, me just getting my body right in general, it's just like that right there is just going to make me healthier and more happy, you know. Just waking up knowing I'm, you know, I have muscles and I have a cardio and I'm in shape and stuff. So
there's a lot to be said. I don't know if you, any of your people read any Eastern philosophy teachings, but there's three centers in your body. There's your intellect, there's your emotional, and there's your physical. And if all three are doing work at one time, that's how you really, you know, you get to feel everything.
Right.
So it's mental, you know, emotional, and physical. And you apply all three with boxing would be perfect.
But another thing is like now it's, I like the way you're saying. I like that. But now I'm so mentally drained because I'm constantly like my life, it's not like I'm not living my life for me anymore. I'm like living my life for other people, like completely. I'm so drained. I don't even talk to you every day. I'd love to talk to you every day. I'd love to be able to talk to mom, call her up. I'd love to be able to talk to my aunts, grandmothers, all that stuff. But I'm so mentally out of it now, you know, with everything going on that, like, I want to just focus and I don't know.
Because you're not, I've been giving you this advice since day one. You have to recharge your batteries. You have to find your own cathedral. You have to find a place where you go, where you can recharge yourself. This way, you know, when you get back into the streaming, whether it's the next day or 2 days later, you're fresh.
Yeah.
And your mind has had a chance to meditate and just decompress. So you don't do that.
No, I don't.
You're burning the candle at both ends. Like, pretend this is a candle. You're burning it here, and you're lighting the candle in the middle.
Right.
And it's just going to burn out instantly.
Hey, Dad, what do you say to kids that want to follow their dreams and passion, but maybe their parents aren't like you, where you're so, like, believing in the beginning and stuff?
Persistence, sincerity. I mean, this is what I read from you. These are the vibes that you gave me. That there was going to be no stopping you. So it's like, why should I make your life harder, you know, and be a drag when I knew there was no stopping you? So I saw the passion. So definitely passion and devotion. There's nothing, to me anyway, there's nothing more wonderful in business and in life than meeting people that are extremely devoted to whatever it is they're devoted to. Whether it's religion, whether it's reading, whether it's streaming, whatever it is, there's nothing like devotion. Nothing can break through devotion.
Right.
So it's for these young people that are having difficulties with their teachers or with their parents not saying this is an open path for you, they just got to make it so clear that there's nothing that's going to stop them. So they could either join you and help you or just get the hell out of my way kind of an attitude. But I realize when you're dealing with younger people with parents, they have to be respectful to their parents. So find a way to be firm but respectful but so devoted. Like Adin, I've never met a more devoted man than you to your business, to your streaming. Yeah. So devoted. Didn't matter if the roof flew off the house and there was no electricity, you know, you would pedal a bicycle and hook it up to the wires and make that generate the electricity.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, that's how devoted. So definitely number one is devotion and sincerity and results. To be able to show tangible results, because a journey of 1,000 miles starts with one small step. So you put enough small little steps together and eventually you'll definitely get somewhere. So they've got to be able to not only be devoted but to be able to demonstrate that they are making headway doing.
So you think that
measurably,
you genuinely believe that anybody in this chat right now could do it?
I believe that a high percentage of the people in this chat that are extremely devoted and amped up to do this can find some success. They've got to find their niche. Thing is, too, not to be too afraid of how am I going to find exactly what my niche is, because that all happens naturally.
Yeah, so everyone,
trust the process.
Everyone's going to find their own exactly purpose eventually. It just comes to you. So how come it comes to some people sooner, like myself, do you think?
That's a tough question for me to answer. Why, you know, happens at different speeds.
Is it just chance or what?
Maybe part of it is luck. Like, when I was highly successful in business at times, I never felt like it was all because of me. I also felt it was because of timing. You know, the timing was right. And I met this one person that led me to this, that led me to that. And before you knew it, everything opened up for me. And then there were times, no matter how hard I tried, it didn't make a difference. There were no doors were going to open. So timing has a lot to do with everything in life.
Got it.
But definitely persistence. I mean, I can't remember a single day, even when you were sick with fever, that you didn't do something to further.
I remember that, yeah. I would be sick and I would still stream and stuff. Remember I wanted to skip my own high school graduation to stream?
Yeah, I remember
that. That's crazy. I just was so devoted.
But you made the right decisions. You knew certain times that you had to just put it down. You know, your mother was going to show me your graduation. What, are you not going to go up to the
graduation? Yeah.
Graduation too. So be respectful too. But let's try to get specific. So could you give me a specific example of a kid out here that has great talent, great potential, but has a specific problem with, you know, a door being shut to him by his parents? Or
like, let's just say as a streamer, I know how many of you guys have parents that just, you know, don't really believe in you. I mean, a lot of, I